I'm going to share with you today some information about one of these groups that your conference is particularly focused on. We call this group the Environmental Assembly. They represent 17% of the entire population of Canada and the United States. Their primary motivator around every decision they make, large and small, is what is it going to do to the planet? They agree on everything, all 340 variables, 82% of the time. That's remarkable. Remember, boomers only agree 13% of the time. So talking to this group, here's some things we know about them. They share an extreme concern for the environment, and for them it's very personal. This is not a large-scale problem that needs to be fixed. This is about what I can do today on a personal level. I take full responsibility for what I've done, and I want to have ways given to me that I can fix the problems that I see around me. They highly value family of all kinds. Now, family these days is a bit of a loaded word. Yes, it does mean your immediate family, your extended family, but your family of friends, your family of coworkers, the other stakeholders involved in any particular project. There are all kinds of different families, and they have a large amount of motivation around making sure these family groups stay together and are all motivated by the same things. They're very motivated, in addition, by spiritual, physical, emotional health and well-being. They are not interested in things that are not about health and well-being. Trying to get them to be involved in your project on some basis other than how they're going to be feeling better as a result of involvement is barking up the wrong tree. They are not, interestingly, politically motivated. Most of the people in this group, remember, 17% of the population have never voted. These are not people who see politics or politicians as a solution to any of the problems facing the planet, any of the environmental issues. So don't try and use political appeals when you're talking to them to get them involved in whatever your project is. Oddly, out of all the 10 groups that we surveyed or that we have in our 60,000 person database, all 340 different variables, they have the most family money and therefore the lowest debt. They can afford a premium for green products and services if their values are motivated properly. They also believe very strongly in higher education and are very likely to have a higher education degree of some sort on their own. Now, what's interesting, huge opportunity alert here, 15% of them will admit that they don't know what to do about how to be more environmentally sensitive. They like education. There's a gap. They want to be educated on a personal level. How can I change my behavior? This was also a little bit of an outlier for me when I found this out looking through the data. They're not so interested in social media. And in fact, if you think about the number of environmental organizations and groups out there who are relying on social media as a way to communicate, this group says, send me direct mail, of all things. An old-fashioned medium like direct mail is their preference. Momentum helps. They like to be part of a group that's headed in a direction. Remember, they like family of all kinds. Carrots help. They like rewards. They like prizes as much as the next guy. Shame does not work. Keep things positive. Keep things upbeat. But they love, like everybody does, a really good round of applause. And that's your cue.